Hello students, in the previous class of ours, we have seen what is the difference between Euclid division lemma and Euclid division algorithm. We will elaborate a little more here and now we will straight come on to the Euclid division algorithm and its application. So see, if I write A is equal to BQ plus R and R is less than B, but can be equal to or greater than 0. This is Euclid division lemma. Euclid division lemma statement goes like this: if you are given two positive integers A and B, then there exist two unique integers Q and R. Satisfying the relation A is equal to BQ plus R, and also another condition it must satisfy is R should always be less than B, but R can be 0 and R can be greater than 0. This was the standard procedure for division, which we have learnt in the primary classes. But writing in this form, we must have come across for the first time. So here, why I said unique? See, once again, I will read out the statement and then I will explain it. Euclid division lemma states that given two positive integers A and B, there exist two unique integers Q and R, satisfying the relation A is equal to BQ plus R. Another condition that it must satisfy is R is less than B, but R can be equal to or greater than 0. Now we will come on to this. If I write 25 and if I write 4, see, here we said given two positive integers A and B, A is dividend and B is divisor. So the unique integers then will be Q and R. Now I divide 25 by 4, so it comes 6. And 24 and 1. The meaning was this, that if you have dividend and divisor fixed, then remainder and quotient will also be automatically fixed. See, if you have 25 as dividend and 4 as divisor, other than 6 as quotient and 1 as remainder, you cannot have. So if the A and B are fixed, then Q and R also are unique. For 25 as dividend and 4 as divisor, 6 has to be quotient and 1 has to be remainder. You cannot do away with this. You cannot have that today you are dividing 25 by 4, here quotient is 6, tomorrow it will come some other, or some other time it will, some other quantity will come. If 25 is remainder, dividend, 4 is divisor, quotient has to be 6 and remainder has to be 1. So that is why we were calling that Q and R will be unique if dividend and divisors are defined or they are fixed. So again, once I read it out for you, Euclid division lemma meant that if you have given two positive integers A and B, there exist two unique integers Q and R, satisfying the relation A is equal to BQ plus R. Now if you want to see, this will satisfy this relation. If I write here 25 and if I write here 4, 25 is equal to 4 into 6 plus 1, you can see it. 4 is 24 plus 1, 25, and this is 25. 25 is equal to 25, and also this condition is satisfied because remainder here is 1, which is less than 4. So this is how it was to be satisfied. And the meaning of the B and A and B are fixed, Q and R also are unique. For 25 as dividend and 4 as divisor, the quotient cannot be other than 6 and 1. Quotient cannot be other than 6 and remainder cannot be other than 1. Now, we will come on to the Euclid division algorithm. For that, let us say two numbers, if I write 4, 5, 5, and another number, let me take as 42. So I told you, by applying Euclid division lemma to these numbers, if we find out HCF of 4, 55 and 42, then what we will be able to find out HCF. So using Euclid division lemma for the given quantities, dividing them according to that rules, and then finding HCF of this, that becomes Euclid division algorithm. So what we will do is write 455 and 42 here, and now this will come in 10 plus 1. Let us see. No, it will be more than that. 420, so this will come 35. So this has come 35. A is equal to BQ plus r, and r is definitely less than divisor. This is satisfied. Now I will write 42 here and 35 here and 35 one jar, and the remainder in this case will be 7. Again, a is equal to bq plus r, and r is definitely less than the divisor. Now if I write 35 and 7 here, 7 5 is 35 and plus 0. Here this step is most important. See, according to Euclid division algorithm, when you find out HCF of two quantities by using Euclid division lemma, that divisor in any step, whenever you find that remainder comes to zero, in that particular step, whatever the divisor is, that is your HCF. So in this quantity, we have seen remainder is not zero, remainder is zero here. Now here remainder is zero, at this time divisor is 7. Please do take care that do not get confused with the divisor and the quotient. 5 is quotient, 7 is divisor. So this time we can say a step Euclid division lemma we will be keep on applying, and a step will come when remainder will become 0, and the time when remainder becomes 0, whatever is the divisor, that divisor is HCF of these two quantities, 455 and 42. Now we will see how it is divisor, how it is HCF. So now if I write like this, 455, and if I make factors of this, that should be 7 into 13 into 5. I believe it is this, and 42 if I write, 7 into 3 into 2. And to make it even better example, if I write 35 here, and I write 7 into 5. Now, this is not the same quantity that we have taken in the previous example. We have changed the quantities so that I can bring home you what is the meaning of HCF in a better way. Undoubtedly, if you factorize the prime factors of 35 are 7 and 5, and for this it is this, let me verify, it is 65 multiplied by 7, 7 5 is 35, 7 6 is 42, 42 and 3 42. This is correct. Now, HCF means what? HCF, highest common factor. This means only this, that out of these two quantities, the largest quantity which is common is 7. See, 13 is not common, 5 is definitely common, but 5 is not HCF of this, because HCF is highest common factor. 5 is undoubtedly a common factor of 455 and 35. And it was because of this that I, from 42, I took the quantity 35, because there 3 and 2 were the factors. So now a common factor is 5 also and 7 also. But 5 is not the HCF, because we have to see highest common factor. HCF means highest common factor. So 5 is not highest common factor, 7 is highest common factor. So this is how we relate HCF of the quantities. And another thing that you must know is that highest common factor, in another words, is that largest quantity which can completely divide these two numbers. If HCF of 455 and 35 you have, that means it is that largest quantity which can divide both 35 and 455 completely, that is with remainder as 0. So this was all about Euclid division lemma, how it is applied for finding out HCF, and when Euclid division lemma is applied to find out HCF, that Euclid division lemma becomes Euclid division algorithm. Now, in the beginning I told you we will write the algorithm of finding out HCF. So how we will do that? Suppose, in general terms we will write, suppose you are given two quantities C and D, and where C is greater than D, and you need to find out the HCF. So the first step that you need to do is apply Euclid's division lemma. Euclid division lemma, apply division lemma, and so what it becomes, now this C is equal to dq plus r, where r must be less than d in this case. R must be less than d, but can be equal to or greater than 0. This was the first step that we were to write for finding out HCF of C and D, where also C was greater than D. Now at this step, if remainder is 0, you can say D is the HCF. Now let me do. Now if R is 0, then D is HCF of C and D. If not, but if R is not 0, then apply Euclid division lemma to, now this time D and R. So what I will write here is, I will write D is equal to R into Q plus, let me say, remainder this time is R. This R has come here. I will apply it like this, and I will keep on doing so. After first step, the quotient, what was the divisor, will become dividend, and what was the remainder will become divisor. Please do remember, after applying Euclid division lemma for the first step, for next time your divisor will become dividend and your remainder will become divisor, and like this keep on going, and whenever you find remainder at 0 at that particular step, whatever is your divisor, that is the HCF of given quantities. Here the quantities were named as C and D, so we can say this is how. Now this is a standard procedure for finding out the HCF. So this standard procedure is algorithm. This is in a particular order it is written, and these are the complete steps for finding out HCF. So algorithm, once again let me tell you, algorithm means it gives us, or it is a set of rules, or it is a series of well-defined steps that gives us procedure for solving a type of problem. Here the problem was to find out HCF of the two given quantities, and these are the different steps, and they are to be followed in this order, and every step is must. So a set of rules or a procedure that you need to apply or that you need to follow for finding out the solution of a particular problem, that is the algorithm for that. So now with this, only examples are to be given, that we will see in the next class.